The second type of incinerator is a modular incinerator. And a modular incinerator has a few advantages. One is because they're built in modules, they can be pre-engineered to reduce capital costs, and you can have a smaller initial capacity and build it up by adding more modules. So you don't have to commit to one big plant right at the beginning. And within these systems, there's actually two types of modules. So one is the primary module, and then the second one is the secondary. In the primary module, it'll be actually a gasification reactor. So what's coming out of that reactor will be a mixture of flammable gases. The reactor itself will be operated with low oxygen, so you don't actually get complete burnout in that reactor. It's really focused on moving the solids and the waste into the gas phase. The secondary phase is where all those gases burn out. So it's kind of interesting. These are separated both to make the construction a little bit simpler, but also to make the actual mechanics of how this combustion reaction happens actually more efficient by separating it out. So here's what it might look like. Here's our primary chamber. You can see the stoichiometric air requirement is less than 100%. So you know you can't have a full incineration reaction there. It's going to be a gasification reaction where we're focusing on producing these flammable vapors. And then the secondary chamber, you can see it's much hotter. And this is where excess air would be applied. And the focus is on burning out all that flammable gas and recovering the energy. So we split it up into two different modules. And it's both kind of easier to make and it ends up being more efficient and cleaner burning as well, because we're really focusing on burning the gas separately from burning the solids. Burning solids is always dirtier than burning gas. That's why burning coal is much worse than burning oil or burning natural gas. Here is what some of those modules might look like in a facility. So in the schematic up here, you can see there's four of the primary modules, and then they're all sharing one secondary module where the gases from each of those will be burned out. And here's what they look like on the floor. They kind of look like compost tunnels or dry AD tunnels. The door opens up, they're loaded up, and then they're started. Not all of them are run in batches like this. This one that I showed you here has a feeding ram, which pushes stuff in, but these ones have these doors that open up. In Ontario, as I mentioned before, we have two thermal treatment facilities. They're both incineration facilities, but one of them is a mass burn style, that's the Durham-York Energy Centre, and then one of them is a modular style, that's Emerald Energy from Waste, which is located in Brampton. And interestingly, the Emerald Energy from Waste facility, even though it's a modular facility, it's actually bigger than the mass burn facility. So it's just added enough modules that it ends up being bigger than the mass burn facility in Durham. And this one has five modules, five primary, and they each have their own secondary. And there's a video for each of them that steps you through the facilities and you can kind of check out and see the differences. So these have been the only two permitted in Ontario. Maybe we'll see more in the future as we move towards zero waste and getting away from landfills. And just to summarize our incineration technologies, on our pro side, we're reducing the volume and mass of our material, so much easier to dispose of it. They have a relatively short residence time and a high throughput, so we can put a lot of material through and get rid of it, basically. They have proven pollution control technologies, which we're going to talk about in later videos, but we've kind of addressed with engineering controls a lot of those traditional human health and environmental issues with traditional incineration. Our outputs, which are our ash fractions, should be sterile, inert, and easy to landfill. We have energy recovery opportunities, typically with steam generation and electricity and heat, and we can also recover materials from the ash. Our cons are these systems are pretty expensive, especially because so much attention has to be paid to the air pollution control side. They're not really good for very wet waste or very low energy waste or waste with a lot of ash in it, so we need to choose carefully what material you want to send to these facilities. We compete with recycling for plastics and paper, which are the best fuels. They're the driest and highest energy, but we know that those are better placed into their respective diversion streams for materials recycling and organic waste treatment. untreated air emissions can be harmful, so that's why we spend so much of our effort on addressing that part of these plants. And then lastly, even though our biogenic emissions are not going to count, just like they don't count from our organic waste treatment, we are putting fossil carbon into these facilities in terms of plastics and other things that are made from petroleum products, and that is going up into the atmosphere, just like burning fossil fuels would be contributing to fossil carbon destruction. So some good pros and some pretty serious cons to think about with thermal treatment. And some of these are partly addressed with our advanced thermal treatment options, pyrolysis and gasification, which we'll dive into in the next video.